Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Everybody knows that we fire and forget. We move forward, we aim at the target, we pull the trigger, we move on to the next target. That's attacking tyranny, waging war on corruption, crashing through lies and disinformation. 1 month ago, I called Paul Watson, and I got all my reporters in a room, and I said, here's a UN and here's a CDC report, and here are major medical journals saying Ebola was confirmed to be somewhat airborne 2 years ago in 2012, and it's clearly mutated. Here are the mainstream documents on that. And it is replicating and spreading at 10 times the previous worst outbreak 6 years ago. I said, I'm no medical doctor or virologist, but I'm reading what all the top ones say as an analyst. This is going to be a gigantic outbreak on top of what's already happened, and it's clearly somewhat airborne. It's gestating longer. And we were attacked, let me not exaggerate, a month ago, by tens of thousands of publications. AP attacked us, others did. That was in thousands of publications alone. You can type in Infowars.com Ebola and see the stuff from a month ago. Paul Watson's doing a video on it. He's doing a report on it. We're going to do a special report Sunday because it's not about defending Infowars. It's about understanding how propaganda works. We presented documents. We presented fact. We tried to warn people. And we said it may not end up, you know, infecting the rest of the world, but it is going to ravage Africa. You know what the headline today is on Drudge from the New York Times? So now the New York Times said it. It's true. Just like the New York Times, 3 weeks after we proved with video and the city manager of Kingsville, of McAllen, and video where the Border Patrol told us to go, our ICE whistleblower, we went and showed the Border Patrol loading them on buses and giving them vouchers, the illegals. We broke that. And we were attacked. People said it wasn't true. And we took the mainline documentation and we put it in articles and it went viral, pun intended. And then we got attacked. Just like they said 3 years ago, we were lying. There were no domestic surveillance drones, even though we were covering local newspaper articles. Just like they said there were no death panels in Obamacare. Just like they said that we weren't funding Al-Qaeda in Syria. Now it's admitted. The truth is, my show is not radical. I get radically upset. I try to get people to wake up. I jump around naturally because I'm upset. That's not a manipulation that I get up here and get upset. But it works because people are in a coma. And it's time for folks out there to get out of their comfort zones and realize we're in danger. And here's the headline out of the New York Times, what we're afraid to say about Ebola. And they talk to the virologist and the World Health Organization, and they say it's going airborne. There you go. So we're going to have Paul Watson and my reporters put together articles showing the videos and the articles where we said this 1 month ago and were attacked. There it is, August 4th, 2014, Paul Joseph Watson. And let's scroll back down. He wrote that 2 days after I told him to. Let's go back to the top. CDC concerned about airborne transmission of Ebola virus. Federal agency directs airline staff to prevent spread of infectious material through the air. Obama then signed an executive order saying for any respiratory illness, you can be detained. And the media said, oh, well, that was just a reissuance of Bush's order. But it expanded it to any respiratory problem, not just specific known pathogens. So we broke it. We were right. It's confirmed. it was confirmed then. We're going to break it all down because now they're saying it's uncontainable. I don't know if that's true. We're going to report when we come back.
After consulting top doctors, nutritionists, pharmacists, and others, we have developed what I believe is the ultimate non-GMO organic Super Male Vitality formula. Super Male Vitality by InfoWars Life is so powerful that I only take half the recommended dose.
I jump out of bed ready to fight these criminals every day. I look forward to waking up and taking my Super Male Vitality.
Visit InfoWarsLife.com today to secure your Super Male Vitality and other powerful products from InfoWars Life.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel body armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel body armor just won't quit.
From the water table to our soils to the atmosphere itself, our world is becoming more and more toxic each and every day. But it's not just the air outside that's toxic. Indoor air has been shown to have 2 to 5 times higher concentrations of pollutants than even outdoor air. And most Americans spend 90% of their time inside using toxic chemicals within their homes. There are more than 42 million smokers in the United States, well over 1,000 types of mold and mildew linked to numerous conditions. And don't forget the fact that 6 million Americans live with pets they're allergic to as well. When I began to research these statistics, it was clear to me it was time to start cleansing my lungs in order to combat the toxic environment that we cannot escape, but that we can fight back against. Made with organic and wild cultivated herbs and manufactured in the USA, the new InfoWars Life Lung Cleanse is here in a convenient spray bottle that can be brought with you throughout any toxic environment. Now available exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
You've heard about the essential qualities of iodine when it comes to your well-being, and you've read the opinions of top experts regarding this good member of the halogen family. Still, reports indicate that iodine is absent in sufficient amounts from the daily lives of countless people worldwide. Now, our extra strength new nascent iodine formula is here, Survival Shield X2, leading the way into the next generation of super high quality nascent iodine. InfoWars Life Survival Shield X2 is derived from 200 plus million year old salt solutions found more than 7,000 feet below the Earth's surface. The result is a unique nascent iodine that is both concentrated and free of unwanted additives, genetically modified ingredients, and completely vegan. We even pre-screen our Survival Shield X2 iodine for radiation. Pure, clean, and sourced from deep within the Earth, X2 nascent iodine is available exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com, InfoWarsStore.com, or call 1-888-253-3139.
Frontal assault on the lies of the New World Order. It's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Monday through Friday from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central Standard Time, we broadcast worldwide. Of course, I then return Sundays, and we'll be here live in studio this Sunday, 4 to 6 p.m. Central Standard Time yet again. That's 4 to 6 p.m. Central Standard Time for the Sunday broadcast. We do have Syrian Girl joining us, expert on Syria, the bottom of the hour to break down the fact that they're talking about arming and paying the Syrian rebels to stop the Al-Qaeda Syrian rebels that I've been told by high-level intelligence analysts are 95% of the rebels, not 65, as the mainstream media has said. Scottish John, who's a friend of mine, local Second Amendment activist, immigrated here from Scotland 20-something years ago. I've seen him out picketing for over a decade for the Second Amendment. He's big on Scottish independence that's spreading to Spain and other areas, including Texas, the New York Times is reporting. He's going to be with us for 30 minutes. We'll cover other news as well. And then Rosa Corey, Democrats Against UN Agenda 21. She's always got the cutting edge intel on what's happening with the global governance through zoning and through UNESCO. So she'll be joining us as well on this Friday edition. If you just tuned in, if you go to Infowars.com, we have the headline, Virologist, it's too late, Ebola will kill 5 million people. Expert says virus will infect entire population of African countries. Now, that story is on PrisonPlanet.com and Infowars.com right now. A month ago, or back on August 4th, Paul Watson wrote the article, because I called my reporters in and I called him on the phone. He's in England. We're here in Austin, Texas. And I said, hey, I've got a stack of government reports, CDC, UN World Health Organization reports. I've got mainline medical journals, 2012, saying that clearly monkeys to pigs in African studies has been transferring the virus through the air. And I said, I want articles written about this. So Watson did write an article, and for TV viewers, we'll put that article up on screen. Also, print me another copy of that, guys. Thank you. CDC concerned about airborne transmission of Ebola virus. Federal agency directs airline staff to prevent spread of infectious material through the air. Now, Drudge carried links at the time to the actual studies. But Drudge also linked some of our articles at Infowars.com. Then, literally thousands of publications, AP, you name it, which is then in tens of thousands of publications, when AP puts it out, came out and said, there is no airborne Ebola, everything's fine, don't listen to Alex Jones, don't listen to Matt Drudge, when all we were doing was writing articles or linking to articles that had been written 2 years ago in prestigious scientific virology publications about the fact that it was becoming airborne. Not super airborne, where it drifts around like anthrax in the air and can live for years, but airborne enough that if it gets in spit or mucus, it can float through the air and you can get it. And now it takes weeks to show up, so it spreads because it doesn't get identified. And there is the myth article, the most destructive myths about Ebola virus debunked. Ebola virus is airborne, waterborne, or spreads through casual contact. That was in the Huffington Post. And they and many others attacked us in a whole bunch of stories. But look at Drudge being irresponsible. Look at Alex Jones. Look at InfoWars. They're fear-mongering and saying it's mutating and saying that it's becoming airborne. We didn't say that. InfoWars wrote articles linking to the mainline medical studies. And clearly, Ebola is more aggressive now. At the time, it was already 10 times a month ago, back on August 4th, over a month ago, 10 times the previous number of people getting infected at the rate it was. Now it's way over that. There's almost 3,000 dead right now. There's over 250 mutations they've confirmed as it spreads across Africa. And the media has been whitewashing it. I remember numbers 2 years ago that there were more than 200,000 rebels attacking the Assad regime and that most of them were al-Qaeda affiliated. 65% was the number the media put out. It's more like 95% now, we know. Today I saw an article, the CIA says there's thousands, thousands and thousands and thousands. Why, 13,000 ISIS people in Syria, 13,000. There were hundreds of thousands, and then half of them or so went into Iraq. The other half have stayed in Syria to loot. They ran out of stuff to loot in Syria, so they went into Iraq. I mean, it's just constant whitewashing. Now, here's the headline today. Doc warns of airborne Ebola. And it's not InfoWars.com. It's